i loro capi. So. And Shalom everyone, Shalom I want to welcome everyone to King James Bible University Precept Mastery and Matter Michael Johnson. Over with the lost sheep of Israel and today we're going to be going to another Hebrew letter. But before I do, I do want to make a couple of announcements that Undeacon Micah will be doing the teaching on tomorrow. So is going to be taking care of a teaching tomorrow because for whatever reason me disguise no matter what now. Ozan is getting in on the mix but the problem is this we have a we look like as might be in is early. 70 segundos or mid 70 segundos however I got a GUI that is not even 30. I actually had to correct this GUI because this lets you know that there's 100% a look at our videos not only look at our videos they try to teach people because they have a lot of complications with their members and so what they do they decide to try to explain what we're teaching which you can't do that because it don't make sense who don't know what the mindset is or what spirit that is on that person that is teaching it so the only way you can find out what someone is teaching you have to go right to the source of itself other than that if someone is sitting there telling you things and just babbling along that lets you know clearly. They absolutely don't know the Bible as this Gui Stephanos and so I would have did better off. 100 better off if you would have went at one of my little students besides one of the deacons who would have been better off. Going after the student that I do have her name is Cammy. Cammy is only about 6½. I would have came out a lot better still would have came out on the losing end but I would have had a better chance. But I decided to go after Undeacon Micah and Deacon Michael will be doing this teaching tomorrow. So make sure if you get a chance to go over there and I will be doing this teaching tomorrow. Because Osanan decided that the verse that they have as you. I was telling about this it's really unreal on how this GUI do it and what I'm also doing so I'm gonna dig into what they like to say they sit there and keep saying they're using scripture but they keep running to their Strong's Concordance which is not scripture but they say a scripture so we're gonna dig into that and literally what happens is we're going to find out a lot more on how wrong and how much is men. Don't know their Bible but we can understand that what they're doing they're trying to keep people there as well as many of the churches are. Splitting and there's a lot of infighting not just a lot of infighting but we have a lot of them now trying to find out how can they keep. Remember there because as I told people before what you got to look at is this when they call themselves the First time to come directly to Megwe was over here at King James Bible University was at 16,000. Right around 720, right around that number, and as we continue to push what we were doing against them. Right now we less than 25 people away from going to 17,000. So we're not losing anything based on the teachings against them, because we're showing you exactly what's in the Bible. However, what they do, they use the Bible verse and then they proceed to try to tell you, with their own things, and I'm not going to share some of the stuff that they can make assert with me what comes out of this mad mouse, but you booted digging Michael going to show you himself, because you're going to let it come out this man's mouse and you're going to say the craziness that they have. So we're going to be doing that, and then I'm going to be going into myself to what I'm going to do another teaching to where I apostrophe me going to make sure we're going to open it up to where even his members it'll be more than welcome to call over, and what we're going to block their names and everything to where nobody won't know on our side know who they are, and we can actually have a conversation with them and they can ask us any question concerning the Bible. So those things we will be opening up, and you will see the difference. So this tomorrow Deacon Michael will be having that teaching going forward. But after that I am going to 100% go right into what they are about, because I'm gonna go into there a lot. More their doctrine, which a lot of times people when they get into this way it's hard for them to wiggle their way out, so the only thing they can do is try to talk their way out. They can't show you scriptures of which you're going to say the seediness that is going to get into, because Deacon Meeting and Deacon Smith happened to ruffle some strong feathers over their while trying to sit there and they're trying to teach against what Deacon Mike and them put out. So we will find out the truth, and Deacon Mike is going to show people a little bit more detail. And what we got to remember is this: many times when many of us teach Moguste was got to try to make sure we be condescended time for other people in the same. I'm pretty sure with Deacon Mike, so I go ahead some more precepts to show you even more so how much is man of that in Jesus part of the Church of Christ are liars, and how they try to keep people in bondage based on their theology or the Bible, and as we do that. We just want to keep that in time. Also let people remind them as we go off to keep that in mind for Dick and Michael Micah tomorrow. And the same is with this here, we sit there and we dealing with this Paleo Hebrew letter that's been taught throughout the world, and they teach you contrary to what they actually mean. This is again another problem that people teach. We they do this way, we don't know what the actual push is to where they try to get you to hold on to something and hold on to people. But what we got to really remember is this: those letters is put there for a reason. Those letters mean something, but the problem that we have is that we have men that has gone out to try to lie to you and tell you contrary to what those letters mean, and they always try to push it to something that makes no sense, and that's the main reason we have a problem with the Strong Concordance, because the Strong Concordance is something that was created by Jewish men, and with those Jewish men you're going to find out as we're going to teach, and I'm going to do a personal teaching on that to show you that the book is 100% alien. You're gonna say that because we're gonna weigh some of the meanings in it, we're gonna weigh those, and the only way we can find out if it's true we got to weigh it against what it's saying it's defining, and that's the Bible. So we got to define that is being weighed in and put it against the Bible to find out if it's true, and if it's true so be it, but if it's false in one point one tittle one sort, then that whole thing is deemed alien. But we're not just gonna find one, we will find many as well as with this his. So we look at his and you look at here and as who go through it, so let's look at some of this we got to go through it. And we're going to say what it's talking about here in heat, so in heat we'll find in Psalm 19119 in verse 33. This is where it gets really funny and many people try to go through it and they try to find different things, but we got to know what it means. To find out what it means and then we can find out how it operates, so let's take a closer look at this. We're going to look at Psalm 119 and verse 33 and it says that it says teach me, O Spirit of God, the way of the statutes. That's a full thought writer, that's a full thought, that's actually the end of that and you say including and so no was going to. Add something to this that sotere says and I shall keep it until. Then so we said to separate thoughts are there and included one because I said I want to learn something but then I want to keep it to the end means going to keep it to the so we got to find out what's going on and this is a, it's a real straightforward one, it's going to shock many people but main thing is they thought you wrong about this, they talk wrong about this and this is the problem because it is the same thing you say in the New Testament as the Holy Ghost, same thing. Same one, same thing, just telling you about the Holy Ghost. And it's saying, teach me, O Spirit of God, the statutes. So a request in the Spirit, this is what David requests that we. Is there asking for a spirit in the name is talking about the why and that's who is saying the why is talking about. The name and that's who is saying teach me, O Spirit of God, the why the name that he keep the statues in. He should keep them into the end so we're going to dig into this, we're going to find out how this actually breaks down. And they started helping us to understand this, we're going to look at something and you're going to say we is focusing on this here, so we're going to focus on a couple of things, so make sure each and every one of you guys write some of this down and make sure that you the focus pieces is what you're going to focus on each piece. As we go through the verses, so we're going to look at John chapter 14 and we're going to pick it up at verse 13. It says and whosoever shall ask in my name is what's exactly what's happening here that will lead also teach me, O Spirit of God, the way of the statutes and he shall keep it until the end so is telling you right up front with Christ is saying and Christ was speaking in this man and says and whatsoever ye shall ask in my name I will do that the Father may be glorified, but we got to find out what that is also that he may be glorified, and he says in the servant is what is saying, so the same thing is what we're doing. We're finding out that if we believe in this why we ask in the name of Jehovah the Spirit of God that we ask him. In his ways and he will do it and it's not a thing where we're looking for, we asking for cars, we're asking for housing, we're asking for boats because that is not his why, that is not nowhere close to his why we're asking in how we can find out how we can keep his law, not finding out how we can get. Come upon some land or come upon some property or come upon some cars for anything else, it's not talking about that, that's what this is clearly saying, we're going to say this as it goes into it, in fact you say this and the Creator will be glorified and while he's telling us this, while we say this here it says it will it may be glorified, it's talking about that the honor, the honor, keep that in mind, you got to be honored, he says and the Father may be honored in the servant exactly the point, let's look at something in John over here in John over. Here chapter 5 in verse 30 it says I can of my own self do nothing. Exactly the point, but you need the Holy Spirit, you need the Holy Ghost and it says as I hear remember we're just working on this. We're just working on this a couple of days ago so as I hear it is so as I hear it is so the same thing as is. Coming from the Father then the Holy Ghost teaches do you say how if running this so whatever the Father says the Spirit teaches that's what is talking about. Right here says as I hear whose Christ he judge teach and says in my judgment my doctrines and teachings is. Just do it because it's coming from the Creator because he seek not my own will but the will of the Father we have. Sent me sent the word that's what is telling you it's real clear it's extremely clear when I say in this so it's not a sin to wears. Telling you something where it's coming from God but the word is from God the word is God. So it's as if it came itself because I sent that message to you and that word came to you and as I heard the word was coming from the Father. Teaching as he teaches judgment his doctrines and teachings is just and since he just is not coming from the will of his son sits. Not like he separated himself now from the Father is still tied to the Father because is the word of God that so he says that in factum watch. This says this in verse 14 over in John 14:14:14. Ese is providing yes all ask anything in my way it's all. Ese in my name my way I will do it not sitting there again not asking for cars and boats and houses and all this. Stuff because it's not seeking his way it's not seeking his way and to show you an example we were at this problem because many. People will sit there and seek to seek things like that they say well you know why pray for this I pray for that and God gave it to me no I didn't you seek this. You hope for something and you achieved it based on you because who constantly work toward that but God don't work that why we could sit. There and say I work that why we're going to put it on them and say well God bless us with it you can stay there all day long and God don't bless you in that why I said anything you ask in my name anything you ask in the why that it work any why that you asking according to my word I will do it because you asking to let God's why not sitting there saying God cannot get this house and then you got a house who oh yeah God bless me with the house no I didn't you achieve that house who got that on your because that wasn't God's why God said God is on covering the house who have is a temporary house how that God has is eternal house two different houses so let's not try to put apples or oranges in mammon with eternal those things are crazy in fact let's look at something weird. Gonna say we're gonna put that one to the test says if you should ask anything in my name you would do it so we want to keep that in mind the reason we want to keep that in mind because we're gonna go somewhere I'm gonna show you a good example on what happened even with Solomon and we're going to look at First Chronicles. Well Second Chronicles we're going to go to one and we're going to pick it up at verse 11 because he had to take over something that his father was doing he was to cover something that his father was doing and he took it over and Solomon said this and God said how can he have something so we're going to look at verse 10 it says give me no wisdom and knowledge that he may go out and come in before these people. You didn't say as wanted a guy I need a Porsche, I need a Bentley, I need a plane. Needed me a big house upon the hill, I need this thing that I can go out before these people, I need some jewelry. I need a watch, I need this type of shoes, I need this hat. He says give me no wisdom including knowledge that he may go out and come in before these people for. Who can teach you say that judge who can teach is the people that is so great. Only God not you sitting there putting on a mighty suit and no you can say. Okay I'm in the money suit now I can go out and I can teach these people because I'm in a money suit that's craziness think about that. Solomon said no I need some wisdom and I need some knowledge so I can go out here and do this was what God said and God said this too. Solomon said because thou was in the heart is was coming from his heart because God don't look upon the Appearance looks on my heart and says thou was not asked riches wells. Or honor nor life was the enemies neither yet as asked long life you ain't asked for this I need a house. On the hill ain't asked for that you want his best car you ain't asked for this thing who ain't asked for you want a million chariots you're not asking for this thing these are temporal things but this is what people will always say when they talk about his because he ain't talking about that when you want to learn something you want to learn a guy it's not sitting there thinking I'm gonna get this and I'm gonna get that when you want to learn to God you deal with God alone and this is what telling Solomon says, because this was in the heart thou was not asked riches he didn't ask for no riches he didn't ask for no wealth he didn't ask for no honor nor life for the enemies neither as he asked for long life he says but as asked knowledge wisdom and knowledge for the self that thou majesty my people not your people my people. Over whom I have made the king you say over whom in not David he made the king. He didn't ask for a car he didn't ask for this car in the hill. He said I want some knowledge I need some wisdom to deal with these people he wasn't seeking the covering was. Seeking the house wasn't seeking honor because honors of the flesh or make me famous but I'm seeking the wisdom of God too. Teach your people so he had to humble himself present his body as a living sacrifice. Holy acceptable unto God in Jehovah Christ come. That you is telling you for is asking for knowledge to understand is not reaching that. So is asking for it. And you say what he says in verse 2 he says wisdom and knowledge is granted unto the wisdom is knowledge is. Granted unto you I ain't gonna give you that because in your heart you're not seeking this other stuff you're not seeking temporal things but the same thing as I was. Talking to one of the deacons earlier today when you do that he wants who you seeking what God's seeking so God said okay well I got to make the same way that it is appear I got to make you appear down there that same way because who want the knowledge and the wisdom but I need to put some things with you no you don't want those things you're not seeking and so you're going to tell in the same thing he says I'm going to grant knowledge and wisdom to you he says include including you say right here, including this, including I will give the riches, including wealth, including honor. Such as none of the kings have had that have been before thee, neither shall there any after thee. Have the light. Might drop the mic at that point. I got to make you look like you was up here. I have to put this with you, you have you want the knowledge, you want the wisdom, but no I have to attach something else to you because I'm gonna attach this to you so when people come they're gonna sit there like man this man wisdom is unreal is that how you got this money no listen to what's coming out this man's mouth same as he told him you say the queen of Atseba she came she started dropping drought kind of dollars. Not based on what he was telling her what she must do she sitting there like man this guy is no joke this man wisdom is unreal. So we have to learn of the spirit of God and we have to learn as a same way. Saint teach me the statues teach me those in factum. He gets a little bit better and we got a look at some law here and get some better understanding in Deuteronomy chapter 4 picking up. At one it tells who that it says no therefore he arken we keep getting to these boys we keep hearing this hearing it's been coming up. Constantly anitzei so Israel unto the statues including unto the doctrines and teachings it's telling you. Writer which it teach you so it removes all men. You with me because Eisue is the body of Christ, it's the Holy Ghost, it's the body of Christ and is telling you right. There it teach you the same as it told Solomon says my people not his people let's just go through says such. As let's look at it it says but I have not asked wisdom and knowledge for thyself that may have at my people that y'all may just teach my people. So as is saying this it says no therefore arke no Israel unto the statutes including the judgments the doctrine of, the teaching which it teach you we just the vessel that sit and says for. To do them that ye may life and go and possess the land with the Spirit of God. Of your fathers he bet you and we have to remember again it's not us. It's not us it's in teaching same thing people sit there like man this we is really good with precepts who can re okay it's not. Me. It's not me it's just a vessel if I was that good then my vessel will live forever. As long as I'm teaching precepts and I'm teaching precepts to God then he should live forever but that's not the truth come just a vessel which is getting old I remember when I was a kid I remember a teenager I remember I was a regular dog and now I'm looking down I'm looking at myself now I'm 59 years old let me know I have more years behind me than you do in front of me. I'm just a vessel that is using to do something and is saying it teaches so it's not me. Let's say something let's build on this and let's say something in Jeremiah chapter 3 in verse 15 in the prophet of Jeremiah says something that actually ties to right to this understanding and it tells who this in Jeremiah chapter 3 and picking up at verse 15 says this says I will give you pastors according to my heart to his heart. Solomon's heart was to God and said so I'm gonna give you some people according to my heart God I'm gonna give them to you according to my heart which shall feed you with knowledge and understand same thing these are going to feed you because I'm going to teach you I'm just going to give you these people I'm going to rest to them they're going to be part of the body of Christ and they're going to teach you you want to learn it teach you oh Lord that statue is in you should keep that to the end okay I'm gonna put some people there I'm gonna put some people there. But these people is according to my heart not according to not they're not gonna ask you for riches they're not going to ask you for money they're not going to ask you to put this in the fund they're not going to ask you this since they're going to teach you what you just asked you said teach you what you need to do okay I'm going to give you these people they're not going to sit there be asking you for some money. This is it's clear this I'm talking about clear today let's look over here Deuteronomy chapter 4 pick it up at verse 5. What is it? Says that it says remember behold remember I have taught you statutes in judgments. This doctrinal teaching that's talking about Moses over here I'm going to give you pastors. According to my heart. That's one of Moses remember I have taught you doctrines and teachings even as the Spirit of my God commanded him to do it same position I mean. Am I nowhere close to him nowhere close and but the Spirit of God can rest on men that teaches this and there. Doing things like Moses, but you not Moses. Moses the only one spoke to face. Moses didn't have to go do this similar to what the put said it to you. This says that Jesus go in the land whether Jesus go and possess it. So Moses go that to rest in Moses. So Moses can do what he was just doing right there. The same said if you're part of the body of Christ, I'm gonna put these pastors out there and they're gonna teach you according to my heart and they're gonna tell you what you need to do. Could you ask anything? You ask my name, I'll do it. In my name, I'll do it. Anything in my name. In fact, let's look at something. Let's drop down to verse 10. It says especially the day that house to this before the spirit of the God in Arab. So here is a special thing and mostly I don't share this. Some of this like this I don't share it, but I'm gonna share it today. I'm gonna share it today. I'm just not gonna share what it actually spiritually mean, but I'm gonna tell you what it was, what does it foundationally mean, but I'm not gonna share what it spiritually mean and herb physically. It's talking about what most people screw up. It's talking about mouse Sinai because that's mouse Janate. That's the point. The point is most of us mix this up and they just think about herb is something else, but if it's talking, it's telling you in one lamp Mount Sinai meaning desert or desolation. It has a complete spiritual name to it that I just don't feel like saying right at this point, but something that you need to know what it means for other reasons. For other reasons, so Mount Herb is a place of desolation, so. Who is this such a place of desolation? Because telling you is coming into this place of desolation is coming into a place of destruction. That's who he is saying this here. It says and studied before the spirit of the God in air and it's telling you this and so in you how this was interesting in Moses. Let's look at something and get a better understanding here. We're going to go to Wisdom of Psalms. We're going to pick it up in chapter 18. I'm gonna drop down to verse 15. You're gonna say is saying the same thing and we're gonna say it says right here in verse 15. It says the Almighty Word lead down from heaven out of the royal throne comparing as a fierce man of war into the midst of a land of destruction. The same thing is telling you about my herb. The same thing, no difference. It's in a land of destruction in earth. On my Zionite because that's where I gave us those doctrines and teachings in the midst of violence and judgment that was going on, but as we gather our people together we can hear the word that have spoken to us to where we can learn to desire him for the rest of our days. Can be the same as we live this day upon the earth and as a teacher to the children same thing as said. Yes, let's look at the says and gather me the people together and I will make them hear my word that they may learn to desire me all the days that they shall life upon the earth including that they may teach. Exactly the pointer children and that interesting that is actually interesting. And this is something we asked for but then when we get it do we actually do it. Verse 34 it says something that says, teach me so if you're teaching we already been harping on it. It says give me understanding, teach me but I need Lord I need understanding with that. Really anything you ask in my name I do it. You want to delete, you want to learn the statutes, I'll put somebody before you. But no, you're going to give that person the heartache because who think that you equal to this person that isn't you interesting, isn't it? So I did this and I do it in that way. It says give me understanding including is I'll keep the law and that's the full sort of it. Says yeah, I'll observe it with my whole heart again a problem the reason is a problem. Because some of us going to do it and some of us not going to do it. Because we're seeking to give us understanding and we need understanding, we only can get it one way. That's why it tells who this who only can get it one way. It's not going to send it to you four or five different ways. It's going to give it to you one way. I only spoke to Moses face to face. That's it. I didn't speak to Yahweh like that. You can't find no in scripture where you talk to Yahweh. You don't seem nowhere where you're talking to Yahweh nowhere. Yeah. We see begged for his life three times, second time, first time, begged, sent the angel to him, sent the message, hey bro, you know, yeah, playing golf, is playing golf, but he came to strength, and you would have talked to Moses face to face. So he's telling us something that he wants us to make sure we clearly get, and this is what he tells us, and he's saying it's strictly got to be done. This way it says to keep that alone, so we have to keep it a certain way, and we can't be bending this, but people bend it to the same thing we get into. This a lot, and you see this over here now in Isaiah chapter 28. Looking at verse 10, it says for a precept must, his commander must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little, but let me explain that to you even saying it that way, because we for us to understand the laws of God, we must keep them, so we need to keep the precepts of God, not the precept of men, and this is what a lot of us do. We're keeping the precepts of men, meaning men doctrines and teaching men that teach us contrary to what the Bible says. So precept must be upon self, line upon line, here a little dear letter, because we have to understand that the Spirit of God part. Sun doctrine in this prophet in part, sun doctrine in that part in that prophet, so you're going to precept upon that precept and precept upon that precept, so it might go precept upon this prophet and precept upon that prophet and precept. Upon that prophet, and then you're gonna have some gonna get right a line of doctrine on this one, and so I'm gonna write the doctrine of the line over on that one, and some gonna be enrolled a little bit here, and some gonna be wrote a little bit there. And what that keeps you in the book one and two, then make sure you make sure God is talking, because if he goes any kind of why contrary and glorify that man as many people seek you know, then you try to make God a liar. No, you're trying to make God a liar, because God said this, and the reason we have to keep those precepts, and you don't the same thing people sit there and say, man, I ain't never heard the precept, I heard you talking, yeah, a lot of people say that, I mean they never heard the priesthood, I didn't know what a precept was until we came over here, and then we say, that's how you run it, because it's telling you right there in Psalm 19 verse 4, it says, thou hast commanded us to keep that precept diligently, because one prophet says a little bit over here and another one says a little bit over there, and he keeps it that way to where we can make sure God is talking all the time, and then when he says three to spirit, you know that prophet or that's that minister or whoever is talking, you know, is using all God's word, and he can't glorify himself nowhere, because everything is so busy keeping up with God. I can't sit there and tell you I need this suit and need that car, I'm too busy trying to keep up with God. I got to say what this prophet said, I want to say with that prophecy, I got to say what this prophet said, I got to put result with that prophecy. I'm busy keeping up with God, constantly shuffling food out all the time, and I'm trying to keep up with it. That's why he says this, and you got many people sit there and say, well, it is free stuff, okay, if it's not running them, you already know it, because who catch it automatically, it's automatic, someone sit there inside the running preselling first and tell say, well, we do this and this is the why we do this in this church. Really, when you're in the church, you're already off, because he said they don't dwell in buildings made with hands, so you already know what's lying from the beginning. As soon as a boom, you already know it's lying, it's automatic. In fact, to me, when you're asking, teach me. And we're teaching according to precepts, and we're going to look at chapter Deuteronomy chapter 12. First we're going to look at verse 32. As it's saying, we're going to look at verse 32 to get this understanding that we got to keep his law. So we're going to look at verse 32. Let's see what is saying more here. It says what seems so every command you because we have to keep his precepts. Observe to do it. Wait a minute, so you say how this is getting us, so we say no Lord, take those statues and that he may keep it to the end and give me understanding that I can keep that law and I can observe it with my whole heart and returns this saying this whatsoever sing he command you observe to do it and thou shall not add there to nor diminish from it, so whatever he tell you, you do it. Whatever he tell you to do it is it telling me to know you I'm nobody is whatever you say in here you do it. And you don't have to understand the said if you pastors according to my heart that gonna feed you with knowledge and understanding and then when you hear what that man saying you do it or no but I don't like it I don't like the way you do this and I seen him no get that out your head what did I say? You say the problem in Jonad you say Jonad a problem in. Jonah was doing all kind of screwed up stuff Epe didn't want to do something but if they say to someone to Jonah when he went into town in Nineveh and spoke against the city no they say hey Jonah what are you coming here for no. You didn't say them say anything they sat there and repented they put on ashes and sackcloth and they listened to the word Jonah they had nothing to do with it because it's not coming from Jonah it's coming from Christ coming from the body of Christ so as the Holy Ghost commands who you will be. Fulfilling what God said not the will of men but of God so these things we need to observe and do and say as soon as they sit there and say you need to give money for this to give money for that you already know it's not scriptural so why are you doing it as a don't add to the word don't diminish from the word and it tells who something and it tells who those precepts have to be run so tightly in factum. Let's look at this interim US it's there and there proves and many things we're going to look at. This in some in Proverbs chapter 30. We're going to look at 30 and verse 6. Let's see what it says out there. It says and thou not until his word woe don't add to God's word that so he tell you I just. Look at me as flavor flag that's why it actually says that because it's in and not a wind to his words at. Liste reprovedi and reprovedi in the soul what we proof is mean reprovedi and you be. Foundly are you guilty reproves it checks who makes who say what you do is guilty. Of a says including don't be found aliar because it's going to approve you on that. It's going to reprove you and it's going to check you so when you're running stuff that so you ever say you can go in any building they call a church you know we got to make sure I'm saying it that while you go into any building they call the church you say then talk about something and the first thing normally come out their mouth they're gonna start bunding money and they're gonna tell you that God wants that. They should be reproved because they found liars because now all of a sudden God is broke. I'm telling you is broke God can't keep up his own house so if God can't keep up his own house we should help God keep up his house. The Bible tells you about a man that can't rule his own house well so you gonna tell me. You want to show that at the man the first thing he do is show that at your God okay wait a minute a man that can't rule his house well okay. I'm cool with that man can't rule his house well how can he rule the house to God okay I'm cool with that okay but now I got one question. What about God? God want that $14 million building okay. Where the money? Where the 14 million knowledge that God wants to build that thing with, because I know God said a couple of things, he said all the cattle on the south and he well no way talking about no I'm. Well, I'm bringing that up, guys. I said all the cattle hotel belong to him, okay, but still guys still need that 14 million, okay, I'm cool with the 14 million. God said in Inagai chapter 2 verse 8, he said the gold is his and the silver is in his head, said the Lord, so let's go to God, because if not, God is not ruling his house well, so we got a problem, but as it says, God never said that the reason he never said it, because it's telling you don't add to his words, at least I'll be reproved and be found a liar, because if God wanted to build that house, God said, he said if I was just hungry, let we go into the small as my new part of God, he said I was hungry, I wouldn't even tell you, so if I was hungry I wouldn't tell us what you think we wanted to build a house. I'm telling you it becomes comical, it's comical, and then when people say that, well, we don't really ask for money, we just get donations. Listen, okay, wait a minute again, so no God is standing on the street corner like everybody else begging for quarters and dollars and everything else, so you got broke for what is a beggar, so your God is begging for money. Begging for money, this is what we got to really get understanding, and all we're sitting there saying is teach me, oh Lord, oh Spirit of God, and give me understanding, so I can keep your law. And the first thing we do, we come in there, they want some money, well God needs you to pay, okay, wait a minute, I want to learn his ways, I don't want to sit there, I don't want to pay as he go, I don't want to pay as he go, in fact, I'm telling you this it becomes comical. We're going to go down to the last part, we're going to look at Revelation chapter 22. We're going to go to 18, we're gonna go to 18. Let's look at something it says, for it testify unto every man, so that includes man and woman. To every man that hear the words of the prophecy of this book, you say how this is going. This isn't good for us, and it says if any if any man shall add unto these things, God should add unto in the plagues that are written in this book. People who's given, excluding people who's receiving, will add the plagues to you, and I say it again. You add to it, you sit there and you agree into it, and you give to it, they add to you, the ones who's asking for it, you agreeing to it, they ask to you, because God says something he already told you. Don't play that, don't add to nothing, so let's look at something, let's pour some more information still, we got to hold the law on this and make sure we're going through it in Numbers chapter 23 and picking it up in verse 19, real clear, says God is not a man, or interesting, but it's so good here, talking about a man, but the reason is saying is not a man that is usually, also if any man add to this who say how this is not going good, so if a man as to this is going to add to it in plagues, but God is saying is not a man that should, and neither the son of man that should repent. That should remember after anything about this, and said it shall not do it. If God sit there and say I want to build my house, where did you hear God sitting there saying when he did for 50 million bucks? Interesting, isn't it? They say, well, you know, God said we were building the tabernacle, and he said give all this stuff for the house. Yeah, he told me something completely different to try to teach you something that was a teachable moment, but most of us have this biggest problem, because we continually sit there and they're going to try to justify what they do. And it's not a man that is ugly, in fact, to verse 9 it says that including if any man shall take away from the word of the book of this prophecy God should take away is part out of the book of life, including out of the holy city. Including from the things which are written in this book unseen writers who do that. I'm gonna do it anyway, even though I'm saying I'm agreeing with him to do it anyway, but I agree with that because it makes all the sense in the world, because we have so many of us like to sit there and we'll build on it, and then we'll sit there in our ideology, we'll sit there and even say that this means the means of God, that all that, so we should sit there and sit there and say, okay, well, this man not teaching the truth, but I still hold this man as a man of God, and you hold him at that honor and no God sit there and say I don't, I never knew you either, you said we not thank you, you this man lying on me and you holding this man at that honor. This is craziness, this is sheer craziness, we'll put a liar in just to kill us too. Honorless. That's who you know, you say people and pay off people and they know we do it all day long, I know people who they call themselves who. It was a bishop or an elder or a deacon or whatever any kind of Christian church of name don't come out of my mouth. I'll call them where they last name, I'll call them by their first name period, I'm not going to sit there and give them a name where they sit in their saying they're teaching about God, and they're using those names because guess what you saying, this man is talking truth and somebody watching you holding that man, that's truth. And you'll make somebody else trip, you make somebody else stumble, so when you make them stumble, God's gonna hold you accountable. So those names don't come out of my mouth because I know a couple of things, one they don't teach according to precepts, two most don't only know what precepts is, that also how you gonna get understanding to keep dry and you can't even observe. It by even observing the precepts that's written in the book. God decide those things in houses God and we got to remember. The place of the house of God and how people was under bondage, but God sent the message to the people that is under bondage. And I will remove you from the book, but people won't still rely on God, and did God give Solomon all that money where they got when God said I'm gonna give you all the riches, I'm gonna make you rich and wealthy. Do you say God ask for the money? Who did they go to did they tax the people you don't seem to talk to nobody? So I'm telling we can't get out of one way for silliness that men teach and we look at this in Proverbs. Mean we're going to go to some cipher God, we go to songs look at 119. Again we got a look at 104, 119, 1104. And it says and through that precepts I get understanding, because it moves man out the way to where man cannot liaise, so through that precepts I get understanding, therefore for that reason, I hate every false way, so when they tell a lie it gets on your nerve, it actually makes who want to vomit many. Times where you even in the presence of some people like that and they sit in their thinking they teaching the word of God. And they don't have the slightest idea when you say freestyle they tell you well where that's in the Old Testament, New Testament, New Testament same free stuff too because the teaching doctrines and precepts are men but they overlook that. So we're to keep this and make sure we're doing all right, but the same thing says in verse 35 it says make me go in. The path of the commandments for the into you delight you say how interesting this it keep getting more and more. Interesting as we're going into it he says talking about that make me go on the path make me and make is create, but you say how crazy this is because people sit there saying make me weird. Making is it no make is create, created me to go in that path with your spirit of God because is going to give you a passage according to your heart, not self will, to teach you the path, they're going to teach you the path, so they're going to make you, they're going to create a path for you to go in that path. There's only one path that everybody has to travel. In fact, let's dig a little bit more, let's dig a little bit more. In Deuteronomy chapter 4, I'm picking up at verse 14. And it says that it says in the spirit of God commanded me that at that time to teach you statutes and judgments that ye might say you ain't saying you're going to do it, said that ye might do them, ain't saying you're going to do them, you might do them in the land whether you're going to possess it. Because you might do it, you ain't saying you're going to do it, some of you guys might do it, so as God commanded his pastors to do as Moses taught the statutes in the judgment that they might do them on your journey, someone might do it and someone might not do it. It says take you therefore a good heed unto yourself, for ye saw no manner of similitude on the day that the Spirit of God spake unto you in her view. You say this pops up again, you say this pops up again out of the midst of the fire. We are you even saying it is why, because one thing you got to remember is this, who need to take it to even the teaching that we that wet here and many times what I do and what I do many times even know where we're getting more serious as we can constantly moving forward we're doing. This is where we teach more and more and more into more parables, but you're no longer under the similar tools of what's going on. The reason you're no longer similar to it because we're so we knew what they are, so the life examples and speaking you in prison except for expiration, so on a successful exploration you are no longer under the similar tools of understanding what the doctrine is, and many of us still are because we're being confused. You're being confused because you want to hold on to the doctrine, so you hold on to the doctrine and you hold on to them to you go don't say you have two doctrines who cannot come before him because he only taken one, not two. No, I didn't know that was well damped up. No, it's not, it's done because you have to trust with the Lord with your whole heart, not part of it. It's very serious about what is doing. Let's go a little bit more, let's go to chapter 5 and 6, let's look at something. We're going to look at 5 and we're going to go to 31:5 and 31:6, this in Deuteronomy. It says, but comparing for thee standing thou here by me, and I will speak unto thee all the commandments, including the statutes, including the judgments which thou shalt teach, and that they may do them in the land which he gave them to possess it. Interesting, isn't it? The reason that's so interesting because we need to listen to the voice of God. But so many people worry about where it's coming from. Is there issue? This is where it's coming from, is where they have the issue at. So this is the problem that's going on. So I will make knowing his commandments in the statutes, including the judgments, and teach them to us. In fact, we may get a little bit more in. In this NSH, yes, I'll observe to do therefore as the Spirit of your God have commanded you, yes, I'll not turn aside to the right nor to the left, period, it's a full stop. In fact, it says a little bit more. Says, and yes, I'll walk in all the ways which the Spirit of your God have commanded you that ye may life, including that it may be well with you and that ye may prolong your days in the land which is our possess, or we seeking to possess the new land of Jerusalem. Some of us are going to make it and some others are not, based on what we're doing. This thing is going to happen whether we like it or not, and many people are going to always hold on to flesh just because people can sit there and tell you things and not show you nothing. They tell you things and cannot show you absolutely nothing, and says this What is we says what they says it says make me go on the pass 40 commandments there unto do it delight. You say how interesting that is and while we're going for watching verse 36 says incline my heart. Unto the testimonies really so incline is really an interesting word because most of us are overlooked that. Word but it's very interesting word because who patio it says unto persuade and as many other. Spiritual meanings but foundational little de mi persuade so it's persuade my heart until the testimonies. So persuade our hearts into the testimony so it can be witnessed as evidence of the declarations of God to seek in the more so we'll talk about it says and not to covetousness and the one and desiring of the things. I'm talking is clear today but the problem is where we seek country things so we need to be persuaded with truth not persuaded with sight. We need to be persuaded with sound not by sight to help us understand that a little bit more we're going to. Still go over here to Samson chapter 10 verse 17. 10:17 it says thou hast heard and desired of the humble. And it says thou will prepare thee hearts thou will cause thee ear to hear that will cause thee ear. To hear. So our desire is for God and we to prepare our hearts to seek His will this desire we must humble. And be seeking this and not with covetousness so when you do that no we're coming I'm telling you as I've been saying before we have to humble our hearts. 100% all the time. So we got to make sure when we do these things we want to make sure all things that we do we trust in God in all things we got to trust in God in all things in factum let's look at this a little bit deeper we need to look at this a little bit deeper and we're actually gonna go to Psalms. Psalm let's go to 71. In 71 verse 1 it says in the Holy Spirit of God I put my trust. But we say because that becomes the focus of we. I will put my trust let me never be put in confusion. So we trust whenever seek to be put in confusion so if we're seeking the testimonies of witnessing evidence of the declaration of God then that shouldn't happen so we do this happen because we truly wasn't seeking God. We truly want seeking God in verse it says deliver me into righteousness and cause me to escape incline again unto me and save me. Say when we sit in there we need to be inclined and talk about we need to be persuaded how because our persuasion is already set there because it's based on what we're doing because if we sit there and tell about what we're doing we are prepared to God we are poor as he says we're poor. So we put we in the world we sit in there trying to be equal to God if we're poor. We are we trying to sit there and we feel we equal to God in fact I mean Psalms 86 and verse 4 it says bow down to your Holy Spirit God hear me and I am poor and needy so if we're poor and needy in the world. We get a little bit of anything we feel. We equal to God. Because we can sit there and we can go after carnal sins and we're not a client in our ears until. The testimonies and we need to and Joshua says something that helped us. Help a fellow Evas in Joshua 24 and we'll pick it up at 23. It says no for that reason put away said the strangers which are among you. Incline your heart unto God of Israel. Because a lot of us going to continue to search and look for strength cause we constantly go to this and I. Really try to figure out why do we go after strength cause because it makes absolutely no sense to do this we say what is will is we learn of it but no matter what. We continue to go after something that is not a goal. While we do this, he do not know, and we continually do it so. What we got to do is sit down, we need to make sure we focus on what we need to be doing all the time and not sometime. And all the time if we focus on this we can make sure that we pleasing God in all ways. So as we continue to go through here in este Linux if we already and you're confessing that you're poor, you're confessing it's not your own mouse can help you, then God can help each and every one of us. But if we sit in there thinking as soon as we get something and we automatically think that we are on the same level as God, then technically you're not poor, you're carnal and what that is saying is this is who he says this is. Turn away my eyes from all the vanity. Turn away my understanding from all the vanity. Vanity can be those same idols and will be holding the vanity we can soon many of us get a couple of dollars in our pockets and we will still be whole vanity. Vain things and right now we asking to remove these things from us, And turn is the one simple one, it's just telling you to overturn. And also mean pass over. Because we want to overturn away my understanding from beholden vanity from remembering. Vanity it says including quicken thou me in that way. Quicken me in that way so I'm going to show you something but I just want you to think about something. We're going to say something and we'll catch it in Exodus chapter 20. We're going to say exactly what is talking about it says thou shalt not take the name of the Spirit of the God in vain. En ese is quicken me in that way over there when you look at verse 37 es it quicken me in that way but es don't take the way of the Lord because that's what name means in a way Lord in vain es is in the spirit of God will not holding guiltless that's a get is way in vain. Is not going to hold these guilty skins for this so a lot of us we have done many horrible things. And this thing that was contrary to God and we sit there we asked for the Spirit gave it to you and we was no different. Than Adam we was all in sin we were all naked. It was not a shame I was not ashamed of this one of our biggest problems we have because we trust in vain sinking. We can do it this way, do it that way and we're trusting when useless things and trusting in people. So as I said, in this way we're getting a better understanding on what is talking about, but as it talks about then we still want to remember how we can sit there and go after another God. Another idol and worship it. It says this, it says let him not, let not in that is deceived. In Job chapter 15 verse 27, in Job chapter 15 31, I'm sorry. Let him, let not him be deceived, it says trust in vanity. Trust in vanity, because if you're being deceived at this and many people going to be deceived at this and the reason why you've been deceived is letting you know who you've been deceived right up front, not something that at second you right up front being deceived at this right up front, and the worst part is who you know it. This is what this is talking about, because it's going to say something about the ones who are willfully being deceived, as saying for vanity salvation recompense, that so yes, saying that's going to be a reward, that is going to be a reward. Quicken me in the way I give you the spirit, but then you don't take it, and then you go another way and you hold on to vanity or something else, and then you looking for a reward for it, and that's your reward, their vanity. Let's look at something. Same thing, Paul says something really interesting. I just want to show it to you. Paul said this really interesting, just want to show it to you. Just keep this in mind. It says Paul talked about really look at verse 6 and go all the way to verse 7. It says, and now we stand and judge for the hope of the promise made of God unto our fathers, unto which promise are 12 tribes instantly. That's the part I want you to focus instantly, serving God day and night, hope to come for we hope, say King of River, I am accused of the followers of Christ. You holding on the vanity, but soon as you know what the truth is, who hear it, it should have taken you and you turn, it should have taken you right then. In turn. And most of us not going to do it on say you quick, and you should automatically turn. In fact, it even says this in verse 38, it says establish that word unto the servant which where who is devoted to the desire is that can anyone sit there and say, oh. Tell me that's true, say you don't answer this for everybody, or let me put this in there, no you answer that for yourself, because people quit my desires to God, no that's lip service. That's lip service. Establish the word unto the servant who is devoted to the desire. Because we have to fulfill this desire. And we're servants in factum, let's look at this a little bit deeper as it told USSS. Say when you're sitting there you want really the body of Christ to come to you, and a lot of us sit there, oh yeah, I went to Christ, I want Christ, and a lot of people sit there profess to have it, oh yeah, I got the Spirit of God in me, really do you, really do you, really you got the Spirit of God with you, in which you mean you wouldn't even have Jesus, we wouldn't even have this Jesus, but people sit there and have Jesus, and they sit in there saying they got the fear of God in them. Can't oh, walk and agree as in about it in 1 Chronicles chapter 17 verse 23 says this, it says that it says no for therefore no spirit of God. Let the thing thou hast spoken concern thee servant, so when you say things like we doom. Deacon Micah then guys out there teaching sin an error and thinking they was correcting something. Some of us run, and as I said, he made it clear they not a friend. They're not above anything because they're contrary to God and God spoke concerning that servant. Concerning his house be established forever and do as thou hast said. So if the word of God is established in us, his desires are our desires. His desires are our desires because they're established in us. Let's look at Psalms in Nogu verse 39. It says this, it says, turn away my reproach which I feed desire with, we want to turn away our approach which I desire. So I say no overturn our reproach which is who desiring good, the reproach is the grace and the same and the abomination that people say you as desire which you talk about what you're doing. It says turn away my reproach which I desire to, I desire to follow your way, I desire to keep your statute, I desire to keep you in love with my whole heart and people reproach me. In fact, to me said this and you'll say where Peter said this and people even screw this up all the time, but look at he Peter actually first Peter chapter 4 says this and you say where Saul tells who it's really apparent. And you say this, it says in 1 Peter chapter 4, and you say in verse 2, it says this, it says, beloved, think not strange concerning the fiery trials which is to try you as though some strange thing happened to you. And rejoice as in much ye are partakers of Christ suffering in the glory, in his glory shall be revealed exactly. The point is says that you may be exceedingly conscientiously with joy says providing each ever reapproached. Exactly the point, take away this, this was what, this is what David, take this away from me because you're desiring to fulfill the ways of Christ and people will reproach you for it. The reason they're going to be approaching for it is anything like tell people, people will sit there and they talk, oh, this Bible, that Bible, this Bible, that Bible, this Bible, that, but soon as who put the Bible on the table and say, let's go through this Bible here, the same Bible that we've been talking about, let's go through it here, all of a sudden it's like you said bad words all of a sudden. You become disliked all of a sudden, you become reapproached evil spoken of. Disgrace and they look at you as the abomination.
They look at you as the abomination.
And it's telling you right up front, it says, tells who take away my reapproach which I desire for the judgment so good. Yeah, they're good, they're not grievous, but they make them look grievous because that's why they're going to say in you to the but the Bible even says this makes this real clear for us. We're going to find this in 1 John chapter 5 and picking it up at verse 3. It says this, it says, for this is the love of God, because we desire to do the works of God. It says that we keep his commandments and his commandments is not grievous, they're not greedy, but people reapproach us for doing them. It's crazy. In time it you we I'm talking about, it's like we can't get out the way either, why we desire God when there was only a plain church and everything was different, everybody's cool with you and people say, oh well, people hate it, don't know that, so you got almost 2 billion Christians out there, but you want to say people hate, no you got 2 billion people out there hate you, really, no, there's 2 billion people Christians. Tell me you can't get out your own way. Verse 48 says this, it says, remember I have long this mean desire. So it said, remember I have desired after the precepts and desired after the precepts of God to seek everything from it, says, quicken me in the righteousness, quicken me in this, don't quicken me any. Quicken me in my righteousness. And this is where we have so people have a problem when you're saying we can me and not righteousness. They said we you want to go cooking in that we you want, but everybody want to be quicker than this until you pull out the Bible. And the reason we're going to be quicker than righteousness, it says this, and what is it's pretty good in Psalms chapter 119, and we're going to go to verse 142. It says this, it says that righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, that righteousness is a everlasting righteousness, because we want to be kicked and into righteousness, and it's an everlasting relationship including Tila is the truth. And this is all I've been talking about the entire time is just telling you exactly what we're doing. So according to the words of this book and the words of God that's coming to you, it says this, and make sure we get this, and we'll say this in Deuteronomy, go back to the law, because you're speaking a lot of law here. We'll do Romans chapter 6 picking up at verse 24. Says this is clear, and says, and the Spirit of God commanded us to do all this statue's interesting, is that the Lord, why that statue's interesting? It says to desire the Spirit of God, exactly what I was saying here, devoted to the fear, devoted to the desire, it's telling us everything right here, everything is here, it says turn away my reapproach of which I desire. But it's telling you to desire the Spirit of God for our good always, that we might preserve us alive as it is this day it is. And it shall be our righteousness, providing we observe to do all these commandments before the Spirit of our God. As he ha commanded us, so it is the Spirit of God. Of his righteousness is statutes to give us understanding, to keep his covenant in his past, these things we seek, and we seek in his righteousness, and incline our ears to his requests, and we are not seeking vanity or temporal things of his knowledge. So as he can set each is his keeps who away from evil his establishes us in the word of his servant says we long we desire these precepts and as we remember, and even in Romans 9:6 it says not as though the word of God has taken non effect, for they are not all Israel which are of Israel, because everybody don't desire the words of Israel. So we that we're gonna go in the back for 4 minutes or two, not gonna be back there long, and where you can see that down if you refresh. You'll say that down already in the Psalm section, you'll say there to where you can get a hold to it, and you can come back there. And everything where we can take care of everything, so just make sure you know what you do, just make sure your camera is on. And we can go from there, so hopefully that each and every one of you guys have learn something from this one when a so we can continue, and hopefully that will be one of the ones that the most high is looking for, and the same thing as I said to my want to make sure that we still remember on tomorrow on UMOC King James Bible University, Deacon Micah will be addressing this even. Usang which is umes nothing but a hidden liar and is constantly doing this. But is gonna actually gonna teach on some things about this guy and what this guy actually said out of his own mouth. As well as umain gonna be going into doctrine again, but he might be addressing the day. Exalted the strong concordance, there's also this strong concordance that they use actually for the Bible, what they actually use for the Bible, so I will be addressing that, so would be con Michael will be doing that teaching over a talking game Bible. Universities, so hopefully we that you know if you guys who care to come in the back you're more than open, so until then. I'll say until next time to each and every person, Shalom.
Shalom.
So. So. You.